Hi, welcome to the series of video lectures on microwave engineering. Today in this session we will discuss measurement of voltage standing wave ratio, which is also called as VSWR. So this article comes in unit 6 of microwave engineering. Let us come to this article. If the load is not properly matched to the transmission line, as you know that if the load is not properly matched to the transmission, what will happen? The reflections will occur. So then the instant and reflected waves both will combine to produce a standing wave along the waveguide. See, the instant and reflected waves both combine to produce a standing wave. So then the ratio of V max to V minimum of the standing wave gives VSWR. So therefore, what is the formula of VSWR? Very simple formula: maximum voltage on the standing wave to the minimum voltage on the standing wave. So this gives the VSWR, voltage standing wave ratio. In terms of reflection coefficient, VSWR is equal to 1 plus magnitude of reflection coefficient by 1 minus magnitude of reflection coefficient. This is given as magnitude of reflection coefficients. So this is the general standing wave diagram, standing wave pattern, which is the combination of instant and reflected waves. So this is the V maximum of the standing wave, this is the V minimum of the standing wave. You can see these points. The distance between two minimums is lambda by g by 2, or the distance between two maximums of the standing wave is also lambda g by 2. The distance between V max and V minimum is lambda g by 4. So these values you have to remember, where lambda g is guide wavelength. Now, the standing wave ratio varies from 1 to infinity. So this is the range of VSWR, whereas reflection coefficient varies from 0 to 1. So this is the range of reflection coefficient, very very important short answer questions. The ranges of VSWR is from 1 to infinity, the range of reflection coefficient is from 0 to 1. Let us see here two cases. There are two cases here. Let us take A, the measurement of low VSWR. So that is, if the VSWR is less than 10, then we use this method. So when this, what is this measurement? This is the measurement of low VSWR. So what is the range of VSWR? So when the VSWR is less than 10, we use this method. Let us see this method. The values of VSWR less than 10 can be measured with a setup as shown below. So this is the general microwave bench setup which we use for the measurement of low VSWR values. So this is the microwave source, this is the pad which works as a variable attenuator. So by adjusting this attenuator, we can reduce the power of the input wave to the required level. So this is the slotted line, very very important component of microwave bench. So without this component, we cannot measure any readings. So therefore, the slotted line is very very important section of microwave bench. So generally, the general structure of slotted line is shown here. The general structure of slotted line is shown here. A slot is shown like this. This is slot. Here, this vertical line indicates the probe, where we can move the probe. You can see this blue one, this is knob. With the help of, by adjusting this probe knob, we can move this probe towards right and towards left on the slotted line. You can see the red ones. The red ones on the slotted lines are the readings that indicates the position of the probe in millimeters, towards right or towards left. So this is the general construction of slotted line. Now the probe of the slotted line, this is the vertical line. The probe of the slotted line is connected to the crystal detector. The crystal detector is finally connected to DC milliammeter. Now let us see how to measure VSWR with this setup. Initially, the attenuator. What is this attenuator? Where this attenuator is? The attenuator is nothing but a pad. Initially, the attenuator is adjusted to give an adequate reading on the DC millivoltmeter. See, this variable attenuator knob is adjusted such that you see adequate reading on the DC millivoltmeter. That is the first, you can ensure that the good reading will appear on the DC millivoltmeter. Now let us see in the second one. The probe on the slotted line is moved to get maximum reading on the meter, which is represented as V max. Next, the probe on the slotted line is adjusted to get minimum reading on the meter, which is represented as V minimum. So as I said that we can move the slotted line towards right or towards left by varying the probe of the slotted line, such that you find maximum voltage on the DC millivolt meter. Note down this reading as Vmax. Now again adjust the probe on the slotted line till you see the minimum voltage on the DC voltmeter. So this is treated as V minimum. So this is how V maximum and V minimum is found by adjusting the probe on the slotted line, by adjusting the probe towards right and towards left. So we can find V maximum and V minimum readings on the DC millivoltmeter. Now then take the ratio of V max to V minimum readings that are obtained from DC millivoltmeter, which gives VSWR. As for the formula of VSWR, what is the maximum reading to minimum reading gives the VSWR. So this is the way we can measure the VSWR values less than 10. So let us see, if this DC millivolt, instead of DC millivoltmeter in the lab, we can also use VSWR meter. So let us see this one. The meter can be calibrated in terms of VSWR. The meter can be calibrated in terms of VSWR. If VSWR meter is used instead of DC millivolt, what we have to do? In this case, the probe on the slotted line and the pad are adjusted to give maximum deflection on the VSWR meter. This full scale deflection, FSD, this full scale deflection corresponds to VSWR value of 1. So this is the very, very important point. Let us see this point from this diagram. So what we are doing here, this DC millivoltmeter is replaced with VSWR meter in the laboratory. So if VSWR meter is taken, let us see first what we have to do. So this is the general diagram of VSWR meter. It consisting of two scales. So the upper scale 1, 2, 2.5, 3.3, 5, 10. So this is the voltmeter readings. So the corresponding VSWR values are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. So there are two readings. Upper readings are voltage in millivolts. The lower readings are VSWR values. So this is the in meter, which this is the pointer which indicates the reading. Now, so what it is said, first in this case, if VSWR meter is connected, what we have to do? We have to adjust the variable attenuator, that is pad and the probe on the slotted line. These both are adjusted. Remember that these both are adjusted till you see the full scale reading, till you see the full scale reading, full scale deflection on the VSWR meter. So keep the pad or variable attenuator now at that position. Do not vary this. Now let us see, that means full scale deflection is occurred. So keep the pad or variable attenuator at that position where the full scale deflection is obtained by adjusting the slotted line and pad. Now let us see, as an example, a full scale deflection of 10 millivolts corresponds to a value of VSWR value of 1. Now the probe is adjusted to get minimum reading on the meter. Suppose if the meter shows 5 millivolts, then VSWR value is 10 millivolts by 5 millivolts, this is 2. Suppose if the meter shows 3.3 millivolts, then VSWR value is 3. Suppose if the meter shows 1 millivolts, then VSWR is 10 millivolts by 1 millivolt, the value is 10. So this is how the VSWR is measured. Suppose, so first what we have to do, we have to adjust variable attenuator and slotted line to get full scale deflection. So keep the pad as it is, do not vary this variable attenuator. Now vary the probe on the slotted line till you see V minimum. Suppose if V minimum is 3.3 volts, then what is the corresponding VSWR? It is 3. Suppose if V minimum is 5 volts, what is VSWR value? Directly you can calculate from VSWR meter, it is 2. In this way, this VSWR meter is calibrated both in terms of voltage and in terms of VSWR. Now, this method will not give accurate results when VSWR greater than 10 is measured. So therefore, this method will not give when the VSWR value is greater than 10. So not all. Now let us take the second method, measurement of high VSWR. So that is VSWR value is greater than 10. So this method is also called as double minimum method. Very, very important. It is also called as double minimum method. Let us see what we have to do in this method. So in this method, first the probe, where is the probe adjusted? In the slotted line. The probe is adjusted to find minimum reading on the meter. So first what we have to do, we have to adjust the probe to find minimum reading on the meter. Now let us see, The probe is then moved to a point where the power is twice the minimum. Let this position is designated as D1. Now the probe is then moved to the twice power point on the other side of minimum, say D2. Let us see what is this from this diagram. See, I have given two diagrams, slotted line. So this is the slotted line diagram and this is the graph. First, what we have to do, we have to adjust the probe such that we find minimum reading. So you can see the minimum reading on this graph. So first we have to find out what is V minimum on the meter. Now we have to move the probe towards the right such that we find the power that is twice that of the power of this minimum point. So suppose if the power of this point is P minimum, we have to move probe towards the right such that the power, you have to find the point where the power is twice that of minimum point. So that is this point. So we have to find that point. Let us designate this point as D2, where D2 is the reading on the slotted line. Next, what we have to do, we have to move the probe towards the left of the minimum point such that you note on the reading of the point where the power is twice that of minimum power at this point. So note down these two points, both sides on the minimum, so that this point is designated as D2, this point is designated as D1. This is in terms of powers. This is P minimum, this is point, these two points are twice the minimum power. In terms of voltages, suppose if this is V minimum point, so as from power voltage relations, these points are root 2 V minimum. So these two points, what is the voltage? That is root 2 times of V minimum. In terms of power, what are these two powers? These two powers are twice that of power at this point. So this is what we have given here. Now, so these are D2, D1 readings on the slotted line. By noting down the D2 and D1, let us see how to find out VSWR. So therefore, the VSWR can be calculated by using the formula. VSWR is equal to lambda G by pi into D2 minus D1. So this is a very, very important formula of double minimum method. So where D1 and D2 are the readings on the slotted line scale. Now, what is lambda G? Lambda G is here guide wavelength. What is the guide wavelength formula? Lambda 0 by square root of 1 minus lambda 0 by lambda C whole square, where lambda 0 is equal to general formula C by F. Lambda C is cutoff wavelength. So this is how we can measure the VSWR values greater than 10 by using double minimum method. So this is what you have to write in the examination, the two methods when VSWR is less than 10 and the VSWR is greater than 10. So by using these two methods. So this is measurement of VSWR. Thank you.